I definitely want to be that role model that I didn't get to see growing up. Brainchild is a science show. We explore various different topics, not only topics that you might learn in school traditionally, like, you know, space or about the oceans, but also science about things that you didn't even think was science, like social media or motivation. In college, I auditioned for Brainchild. I sent in a tape, sort of set up in my room. You could tell I was like clearly in a college bedroom, you know, my bed wasn't made, whatever.
The strange thing is, people, including adults, have irrational thoughts all the time.
I have been getting positive feedback from kids, Indian American kids and women, who want to go into acting, but also into STEM fields. And I feel like I have this great opportunity to, you know, encourage kids to go into both and see that representation that they need from both sides. There's a little girl, I think she is a young girl of color, and she had dressed up like I do in the show, and her mom told me that she would go around her school saying like, "Do I look like Sahana? I'm trying to look like Sahana today." And that's really cool because it shows that she has someone who looks like her that, you know, she can look up to. When you're a kid especially, it's so easy to feel like a misfit and alone. Even now, like, just regardless of your age, it's important to have role models who look like you in the media. I mean, everybody watches TV and movies, and that's just such an underrated platform for, you know, making you feel less alone. I definitely want to be that role model that I didn't get to see growing up in the media and on screen. It's definitely something that I strive to do, but at the same time, I don't want to say that that's all I'm about, you know? It's not like I'm defined by being an Indian American actress. I'm also so many other things. Like, I might do jokes in my stand-up or, you know, create short films that do focus on my background, but I can also choose not to. I think it's important to recognize that I have that choice. I mean, representation, it's an issue that's getting better slowly. And a lot of that was fixed by people of color, like making their own content, like Mindy Kaling. She made her own show and then she's the lead in it. And that's also something that I realized, was that like, I'm not gonna get cast in everything. Why don't I just make my own stuff? And which is why I really got into filmmaking and making my own little monologues or impressions and stuff. Laughter is like a feeling that you can't really, it's something you can't control. And so it's their way of agreeing with what you're saying without even realizing it, which is why comedy and art are such good platforms for talking about important messages, because people laugh and then later they'll look back and be like, "Oh, I wasn't really on her side, but I guess I am now."
Things aren't looking too rosy for the Rosies.
A lot of art and acting is definitely very self-motivated. Just talking about my personal experiences in an absurd way, I think, is what I like to do. And with short films, I also like to incorporate aspects from different cultures that I grew up in. I don't want the world to expect only that kind of content to be made by me. It is important to recognize that it is a big part of who I am, just growing up and feeling like a misfit and not belonging to either culture sometimes, and then later recognizing that I could, you know, blend everything together. People are complicated, and that's okay. You can explore various different paths, and I'm lucky to be able to get the best of both worlds by doing Brainchild.
Visible is the new way to think about phone service. Just $40 a month, all in, for unlimited messages, minutes, and data at speeds of up to 5 megabits per second. All on Verizon's 4G LTE network. No hidden fees, no annual contracts. When you think the future of phone service, think Visible.